Hey guys, good evening. Well, if you remember, I've been following this crash from the moment it happened and have built a strong relationship with Desiree Effort. So pictured right here, she lost her daughter Haley right here. This is her son-in-law Aaron, and right here, 3-month-old baby girl, that's her granddaughter, her name is Tesley. After 6 months of anguish, she told me she's finally able to sleep, especially last night after hearing that news.
On June 13th, Aaron Godinez and Haley Everts, an engaged couple, their 3-month-old daughter Tesley, and Aaron's parents were celebrating a birthday in Denver, headed back to Wyoming, when this crash happened, killing them all.
She was my firstborn. She was my baby girl.
Grief-stricken, Desiree Everts spoke with FOX 31 right after the crash, praying for justice. That day is today. Jesus Puebla has been arrested and charged, accused of causing this fatal crash on I-25. Police say the 26-year-old was behind the wheel of this semi-truck that plowed into the back of a family's vehicle at a high rate of speed. Everts told the problem solvers back in July, and police records now show that Puebla was traveling 76 miles per hour while this loving family, stuck in slowing traffic, was going less than 10 miles per hour on impact. Initial reports back up today's police records, investigators finding that Puebla made no effort to hit the brakes or steer to avoid the collision. We're learning today the truck had several brake violations.
From my perspective, a company has to be responsible for its drivers, and this company was not responsible for its driver.
Denver attorney Dan Salone specializes in trucking crashes and weighed in after records showed Puebla's commercial driver's license was canceled. The 26-year-old did not have a valid medical certificate, but got behind the wheel illegally. Although Everts knows nothing will bring her family back, she told me just today, quote, I would just like to say our families have been praying for this day since it happened and are so grateful there's finally starting to be justice served for our angels.